Yeah. And Carl, we have to keep in mind here that this was an investigation that the president called for himself with unsubstantiated claims or an unsubstantiated tweet. The White House now says that President Trump never really thought it was Obama specifically, but you know, we go to the original series of tweets here, like this one. How long has President Obama gone to tap with two P's, by the way, tap my phones during the very sacred election process? This is Nixon Watergate, bad or sick guy. That seems pretty specific to me, because they're saying these quotes mean a difference. They're not saying the misspelling of tap means anything. It's just so weird, the random things that they say mean something and that we should glean from it. I mean, what do you think here? That seems pretty specific to me, especially when you say bad or sick guy. He's talking specifically about the former president himself.
It's not weird and it's not random. It's very purposeful that Donald Trump's lying and maliciousness is intended. He is not interested in the truth, particularly about anything having to do with his own conduct, with the conduct of those around him. He's trying to deflect attention from the investigation going on into the Russian hacking of the DNC and whether or not there is some connection with people around Trump. He's got to be considering the lying of Mike Flynn, his chosen national security advisor, the lying of his own attorney general about how or whether he talked to Russians, in this case the ambassador. We are looking at a presidency that is encased in a bodyguard of lies. And that is Donald Trump's problem. We've never had a president in such a fact-free environment before, including Nixon, including Clinton during the Monica Lewinsky thing. Clinton lied. Nixon lied. Nixon had a criminal presidency. But where we are now in terms of every day, a fact-free environment with a president who recklessly puts out this stuff with no basis in truth is new territory. It's dangerous. And we got to see where it goes.
So you're saying this is more lies than any other administration that you can remember, that you can recall?
In a systematic way. Look, yeah. Nixon lied to cover up a criminal conspiracy of which he was an integral part. What we are seeing here is a president, a character with a long record of lying and fabulous statements in his career before he ever came into the political process. During the campaign and since he got to the White House, it has been a fact-free environment, the likes of which I have never seen I've been in journalism 55 years, 57 years actually. I've never seen anything like it, and I doubt that anyone else has.